small muscles. Now this is very important drawing because you know how to draw small muscles again in your second class also. So you should be able to draw it properly and move it properly. Now small muscle fibers, they are spindle shaped fibers, that is which have central thicker part and it's tapered at the margin. So you will just give color inside, even color, and draw it. This is another small muscle fiber. Do not join their edges, but draw tapered spindle shaped fiber. So this is one row. Each small muscle fiber has the central rod shaped nucleus. You are not going to make margins of these cells because they are not prominent due to overlapping of the cell. Now the arrangement of these muscle fibers is such that in the next layer the thick part overlies thin part of the muscle fibers in the next layer. So you will draw it very close and you just again give even color to it. Do not make margins prominent, and with your thin pencils, sharp pencils, draw these cells, otherwise you won't be able to draw them properly. Now again you can see I have drawn next layer, taking care that thick part of the muscle fiber should overlap thin part of the muscle fiber in the other layer. Again rod shaped nuclei in the center. Then move on to the third layer. You will again start from here, so that thick part is now being overlapped by the thin part. The arrangement of the muscle fibers should be such that thick part should overlap thin part. I am repeating again and again because it's very important. You should not overlap thin with thin and thick with thick. Overlap thin part with the thick, and thick part should overlap thin. If you draw muscle fibers like this in successive layers, the nuclei of all these muscle fibers, they will overlap each other, and this is wrong. They should come in this slant direction. You see the muscle the nucleus is not overlapping the nucleus of other muscle fiber in the successive layer, but they are in the form of slant. Now again, thick part should overlap thin part. And if you draw these muscle fibers elongated, they will be more beautiful and long. And if you are able to draw them properly, then most of your diagram will be beautiful diagrams. So this is how you draw the longitudinal section. They should, all the layers, they should have very small space in between. Because if you give too much space to the layers, they appear to be separate and they do not appear to be in the form of fluid. You can see here that the muscle fibers, they are in a form of a sheet appearance, and the thick part is overlapping thin part. Now for the transverse section, you will form this connective tissue and you will form two loops. If we make a section of this, you will get this section, you will get this section, you will get this section, you can get this section, this section, this section, this section. So sections or transverse sections have muscle fibers of variable sizes and shapes. The larger section, which is this one, will have nucleus in the center. You will again give shade inside this and you will just give form nucleus in the center. Then there is smaller section which is cut from the margins or edges that does not contain nucleus, so you will not draw nucleus. Only larger section will have nuclei, so form nuclei in the larger section and draw other section of variable sizes of this size, of this size, of this size, so fill it up with them. Yes. That's all that you have to do.